Yep. Alright, next episode. Yeah. Excited. I'm excited. It's the last episode. Whoa. It's cool. We'll stream GTA 5 a lot. Surprised how many people come in. Yeah, a lot of people like GTA. It's good. It's good, good. So what were you doing, like, GTA? Just, like, fucking around, or, like, were you, did you have, like, a purpose you were doing? Oh. I went to go say good morning, and then my popcorn came back on, ma'am.
I mean, apologize. Your eyes and the teeth, you're not really supposed to do that, are you?
Help. Good morning, Nova. How are you, though?
Not if I can avoid it.
Oh, yeah. In case anyone didn't know, we ripped somebody's throat out. Just don't worry about it. Did high submissions? That's cool. It's a head.
No.
No.
Holly's sister, Lily.
Do you even give a shit?
You gotta go to bed, Diesel. All right. Hope you sleep well, and I will catch you another time.
It's the ribbon, isn't it?
And yeah, if you're not following him, go do that.
We're destroying the tree
here. That are here.
No.
You got interviewed for a job today? Well, I wish you lots of luck on that job interview.
Hey, you're not really going to send me to the farm, are you?
Look, maybe a few will get sent up, but you're my friend, Colin. I wouldn't do that to you.
I'm going to play with my phone. And I'm going to take my trash out. Which is going to be after the garbage people come, so it's like no point.
Oh, God, Bigby!
This time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial.
Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
Yeah, great deal. The Crooked Man dude. Like, he reminds me of somebody. Like, he reminds me of a character in another game, and I can't remember who the character is. Which sounds bad, because, like, how's he remind you? I really like the music in this, like, opening sequence thing. Like, it's really nice music. Very like, you know. Episode 5. The last episode.
You've come a long way. You must be tired.
Uh-huh.
And if my envoys are correct, you haven't had a lot of rest recently.
Gonna shoot me? Hobag? Yeah, I fucking stabbed you with your own hand earlier.
Sheriff, relax for a moment, will you? Do you want a drink? Something to eat. Vivian makes a very nice, very... It's elegant. Really, a carpaccio. It's lobster. Sirloin.
I'm here for one reason, and it's not to eat your fucking food.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think you're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So yeah, don't waste the silver. Sit down, Jersey. Well, Sheriff.
Stab you with your own
For the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here? It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You know why I'm here. You killed those women.
What women?
Faith and Lily, the girls who worked at the Pudding and Pie.
Did I now? I assume by your confidence in accusing me, you must have some proof of this, yes?
Nah, I got nothing.
Some allotment of evidence. A witness, perhaps.
I know you did it.
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I wish you had me dead to rights. I really do, for your own sake. But no, I didn't kill anyone.
Damn.
Those women. I don't relish telling you that the killings were perpetrated by an employee of mine. It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally.
His eye freaks me out.
I just want to settle the issue for you.
An unfortunate bit of business? You're gonna tell me right now who killed him.
Who got it?
I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that. But I simply can't divulge that information.
I just want to know who done it.
You really shouldn't worry yourself. As I said, I've got this under control.
No, I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation?
Hey, I kill you like I killed your brother.
The man said he'd take care of it. So why don't you take the hint and get out?
I'm the law here, not you. Now tell me who did it.
Or what? You're gonna kill me too?
Yeah, well, I am. Ahead.
You think I give a shit anymore? After what you did?
That's enough. I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but in the interest of preserving our alliance, if you have to know, it was Georgie.
Really?
However, like I said, I'd be handling the matter if you don't mind.
Georgie?
You got what you wanted, so just...
Sit down. Now.
Yeah, I killed him, so what?
Why'd you do it? Why kill them?
Does it matter?
Look, the fact is, George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. But you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this!
And
you
then attempt
me to
blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
This is right bollocks, sis. You're just gonna let him do this?
So what do you say, Sheriff? Can we discuss terms? You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift, ensuring our continued cooperation.
All right, let's talk.
You can't just hand me over! What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us!
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like
you
that?
You think I'd give a fuck if I'm the one... Who the shit do you think you fuckers
just
are?
Get the fuck out of here!
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him! Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere. I'll roll over on the lot of you before I let that shit happen. Get the fuck away from me! He's the one you fucking want!
This could have gone so well. But you just had to complicate things. To speak the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
Oh look, Bloody Mary, the bitch is back.
Did I miss anything good?
Yeah, I'm gonna fucking rip your throat out now. Intense cue.
Over here.
Oh shit.
You're done, Wolf!
Come on. We're pretty much done here.
He's more important to me.
I'd like to say it was nice knowing you.
Yeah, you stabbed him. Look what you done did. Intense cue.
Oh god.
Oh, I fucked up. Is it intense cue time?
This way.
Can I kill him? Please let me kill him. I want to kill somebody. I want to kill somebody. I just want to kill somebody.
Come on,
buddy.
Oh, shit!
I know. I know. I should have got that one. I don't care. Up, asshole.
Gun it.
Are you sure?
Do it.
He's not moving.
Keep going.
Just stroll across the street and like, yeah, see shit.
Holy shit.
Come on. We can't stay here.
Hang on. I need a minute.
Okay.
Shit. Hello, Bigby.
I hope you'd come to your senses. Crooked Man's the one you want. But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go.
I'm taking you in, Georgie. Let's go.
You're gonna carry me?
Please, Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
You can't seriously want to protect this guy. You know what he
did. I'm not going anywhere. It isn't his
fault. He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're
dead. Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all
have.
What? He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Girls,
so it's all my fucking fault then. You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf too. You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck? I did what I had to. You can't fucking blame me for that.
Look,
Sometimes you just have to do what you're told.
Why'd you do it then, huh? If it's not your fault, then what the fuck happened?
Look, Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the Crooked Man wasn't too thrilled. But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Cause it's not my fault. The Crooked Man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out.
You're still the one who pulled the trigger. Nobody held your hand and made you go through with it.
Fine. Believe what you want. I can tell you've made up your mind. Doesn't matter if it's fucking true or not. Go ahead and arrest me then. But it won't bring back Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing. It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault. But what was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know?
You could have done anything else. You could have let them go. You could have freed Faith and Lily from those fucking ribbons instead of murdering them.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them... What would you have me do? Kill her?
Georgie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die. Do you still think I had a fucking choice?
What are you talking about?
This is the original. The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off. Couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
You promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
You can't fucking blame me. You're not innocent here either.
Wait, so you've been helping this asshole? I thought you cared about them.
I do. Of course I do. You have to understand, nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were gonna be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. Then the Crooked Man showed up, and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her, then.
What are you doing?
Break the spell. Save the fucking day.
We'll find another way. She doesn't have to die. Maybe the witches
don't
can...
Don't talk about me like I'm not even here. Please. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say? It's my life.
You're right. It's your life.
I know what I've done.
Wait.
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here, but it's all the fucking same.
Vivian, I didn't mean...
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily? To all of them?
Vivian, wait!
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them, what I took away from them. I look at Nerissa and I hate myself.
Vivian!
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing?
Vivian, don't! Vivian! Rudy. No! Fuck! No!
Why'd
you have to do that, Vivian? Vivian!
Just... Jesus.
Vivian, I didn't fucking mean it. I was just...
She killed herself. She took the ribbon off.
Oh, fuck!
Get up. Get up!
Don't think so, Bigby. I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the crooked man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right?
He's gonna have it worse. Worry.
Good.
All right, Georgie,
old
I got you that.
By the river, all right?
I don't think you're a piece of shit, though.
He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You want to finish me off now? Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one? That's what you want to do, right?
That's not who I am.
You gotta go back to
sure
bed together with the planner. All right, good night, Nova.
No more games, all right. We both
sleep
know how
well.
This ends. Just make it quick.
Kill him.
All right, Georgie.
We just Well, we put strip club out of business because we killed everybody. Except Nerissa. We saved her. It's a pretty sight to come back to. Welcome back, Crab. Skeeved me out, man. That was worse than fucking him fixing his arm. Gonna walk all serious.
Of course.
Locked. Great. Intense cue. Not as intense, actually. You're just opening a door. More intense when like somebody's trying to kill you and you're like, cue! Save me. Like that Mary bitch. She fucking stabbed. Oh no, she shot us. That was fun. We almost died. It was great. Actually, no, we did die. But then we came back because it's fine. packages.
So this is where they've been sending these.
Alright, I guess we're just gonna open the door. Oh, is this the light? I don't like this. Like, it's just like, I can't do nothing about
Maybe
it.
Maybe won't.
I don't like it. Oh, this bitch!
The big bad wolf.
It's this Mary bitch again. God damn it. I hate her. I really do. How do I get...
You used to be something.
Yeah, so did you, bitch.
They used to fear you.
I'm in a lot of these pictures.
They'd hide anywhere their small shivering bodies would fit.
Silver bullets.
Silver.
The big bad wolf.
You gonna try to shoot me, bitch? Oh, girl?
It's about time you showed up.
I had to take care of some things first.
Little errand boy. That's nice.
This Mary bitch. I hate her.
I see you made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find me when you've finished, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way, now. Don't make this worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
We're gonna hit her.
Wow, what a man. Stealing punches while my back is turned? Didn't your mother ever teach you to fight proper?
I hate this bitch. See, she does this teleport bullshit. That wheel. The wheel. She's like Predator or some shit, man. Dangerous, but it's fine. Ho? Please don't put me in control of him. Oh. It's too late. I'm slow. No, I hit it. Oh, bitch, you're a tit.
Where are you? Come out and face me.
Oh, fuck this. Fuck this. Oh, hell no.
Oh,
I'm not going to sleep. I get her. Please tell me she doesn't come back, because I can't deal with this. You looking at my dick?
Hello, Bigby. You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
That's a good reason.
This gun holds 6 rounds of specially designed silver bullets. Now, I may not be the best shot, but I can guarantee that at least one bolt will meet its mark. And you'll find yourself rolling on the floor in agony, unable to heal yourself. Without Swineheart to save you, you'll die. Is that reason enough for you? Yep, before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she? And that's what I want.
That's right. But what happens to you once you get there is a different story.
I'm not quite finished. You will bring me back alive. Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community. And I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial.
The whole town will be calling for your execution. Why would you want me to bring you back there?
Why don't you let me worry about that? Look, there's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand. I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women. And I think you know that. All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
You're not a killer? Then what are you?
I'm a businessman, not a killer.
There's still a lot you have to answer for.
And I will, as long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community. I don't mean to belabor the point, but just so we're clear, if you change your mind and decide to do something stupid, you won't get your answers. But you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned, I mean. Do you really want the truth? Or do you just want to look like the hero?
This is about justice. I'm the sheriff. I have to do what's right. Two people were murdered.
And you know who did it. Georgie. He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in. But you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going? I'd rather not dawdle.
All right, let's go. Hand over the gun.
I think I'd rather hold on to it, if you don't mind. What do you say? Fine. I'm sure Miss White will be pleased. Such a reliable pup. I understand why she'd want to keep you around.
You're under arrest. You'll be given a trial in front of your peers. And your punishment will follow.
A little anticlimactic. I really want to kill him, but I don't want my bitch to be mad at me. Plus, like, I kind of like the Crooked Man.
I know. But we have to do something. Are you fucking kidding me?
When is this thing happening?
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, you'll have an opportunity to... He's back.
The Crooked Man.
Thank God.
Motherfucker.
Mm-hmm.
Are you okay? It's been hours. We were worried you'd run into some trouble. At the Crooked Man's place.
It's nothing. I'm fine.
I guess you've been worse. You did well, Sheriff. I'm surprised. Not that you did well, but that, you know... I'm just glad you made it back in one piece.
It's about time you showed up. Now throw this asshole down the fucking well.
Yes, what are you waiting for?
You killed Lily!
She was my sister!
How could
what
you?
What do you have to say for
Where
yourself?
The fuck do you get
Those
off?
Poor girls.
You think you have the right
and
to just do
fate?
This to
what
people? You're a fucking crook!
This? You should
fucking
be ashamed.
Shithole.
Everyone, can I have your attention? Thank you all for coming here on such short notice. I know normally we'd schedule a formal hearing, but considering the circumstances, I thought it best if we do this as soon as possible. The Crooked Man is charged with the murder
as
of
I
Faith
already
and...
informed your sheriff, it was Mr. Georgie Porgy who killed those women, not me.
What? It was Georgie?
Georgie may have killed them, but you made the call.
Do I have to explain the situation to you again?
Wait a minute. So you're saying Georgie's the motherfucker who killed my sister? Well, where is he?
Yeah, you're gonna bring that shithead in too, aren't you?
Yeah, Sheriff. Where is the rotten scoundrel now?
Is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not.
Well, where is he?
Sheriff?
Don't worry about it. It's done.
Justice has already been dispatched. Bigby executed him.
He's... what?
Dead. So you see, the culprit has been punished. There's no need
for this. That doesn't change
anything.
We'll deal with it later, but right now, you're the one I'm concerned with.
You called the shots. Georgie made that perfectly clear.
In which case, you still have a lot to answer for. And
I told I would be allowed to speak.
We have to read the rest of the charges.
What other charges?
If you'd wait a moment.
I'm well aware of my rights, Miss White.
Let her finish. Then you can have your say.
Got it?
If you insist.
You are charged with the murder of Faith and Lily, which Georgie carried out on your order, inciting violence against various members of the Fabletown community, including the attempted murder of Sheriff Bigby Wolf.
Twice.
A misunderstanding.
Aiding and providing monetary support for the forced prostitution at the Pudding and Pie. Additionally, you are charged with multiple counts of fraud, extortion, racketeering, and the illegal possession and sale of magical artifacts.
And kidnapping Crane at gunpoint.
He went willingly.
Yes, thank you. Now, is there anything you would like to say?
First of all, I had nothing to do with Faith and Lily, so you can strike that one from your little record book.
Bullshit! Like hell you didn't.
Stop the charade. We know you're involved.
I know you're responsible. You've been behind all of this from the beginning. So cut the shit.
We all know who you are. We know what you've
Just
done.
Just give it up already.
The Crooked Man has committed crimes against this government and, most importantly, its citizens. These charges, if proven, are enough to justify death. Upon which, your body will be committed to the witching
Where
world.
It fucking belongs!
That's
so
right.
Let's get
but
on
we
with
promised
it then.
You a chance to defend yourself. And I won't rob you of that right.
What the
really
fuck?
Want
this
to let
is
him
about
talk?
Justice. If we're ever going to pull ourselves together and make something of this town, we have to start doing things correctly. No more snap judgments, no more secrets. We are going to treat everyone fairly, even when they don't deserve it.
This is ridiculous.
You have the floor.
Thank you, Miss White. You've all met Georgie. I don't have to tell you what kind of person he was. He was a total scoundrel, lacking in any sort of moral fiber. I hired him as a favor to his family, you see. A promise kept to a dying mother.
Oh, jeez.
Are you gonna get to your point or what?
Georgie was working for me, yes. But he was not acting on my behalf when he killed those women. It was his business. And for whatever reason, I'm sure only he could understand, he murdered two of his most faithful employees. I had nothing to do with it.
Tell
this
him
is
a fucking
such bullshit!
Truth.
Georgie seemed pretty convinced he didn't have a say in the matter.
He clearly misunderstood my intention.
Really?
I would never authorize such an act.
Any of you actually believe this bullshit?
Holly, please.
Tell them, Bigby. When you finally showed up at my door last night, wasn't I more than helpful? I answered your questions. I was willing to cooperate.
You weren't being helpful. You were trying to set me up. Your people tried to kill me.
They get a bit carried away sometimes, it's true. Loyal to the end. They do it because they want to protect me, as I protected them. You understand wanting to protect what you care about, don't you? You'd do anything. You might even give up an innocent man, just to save someone.
What's he talking about?
I really hope you're going somewhere with this.
I see, you want to cut right to the point. I can appreciate that. Let me explain this to you. My employees are just that, hired help. I see some of them are here among you. They are not my slaves. They are all free to make their own decisions, as Georgie was.
What about Lily? She wasn't free. She wasn't given a choice. Do you really think she wanted... that any of those girls wanted their lives like that?
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry that your sister asked me for help, and I'm sorry that I decided against my better judgment to give her a distasteful job.
Right, and you kept them in debt so they couldn't leave.
Yeah, that's what you did to us. How you kept us all
you
in line.
You forget it was not me who put you in that position.
You all act like I'm some kind of tyrant. When your government abandoned you, left you poor and helpless, sniveling on street corners, I was there to look out for you.
Yes, but...
Wasn't I?
Crane was the one who let this town go to the fucking dogs. The guy who was in your pocket, remember?
Really?
What about Auntie Greenleaf? Her story is not uncommon. She left everything she had back in the homelands. Everything that matters, anyway. With nowhere else to turn, she came to me for help. And what did I do for you?
You got my tree back.
I got her tree back, and in turn we used her magic to help poor Fables get glamours. Because I helped her, she was able to make a living, provide for herself. And what did they do?
She wanted my tree destroyed, but Bigby refused.
What?
You were gonna burn her tree? Snow, why would you want that?
Is that true? I know. Snow made a mistake.
I had very good reasons for asking you to do that. She was working with Crane and the Crooked Man.
It wasn't her fault.
You can lie to yourself, but you can't lie to me. You hated Crane, and you hated him for wanting to fuck you, and you being too soft to notice what he'd do to get it. It had nothing to do with the Crooked Man.
We've made some mistakes. I've made some mistakes. But believe me, I truly want what's best for this town. And that may not always be clear right away, but I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And so does the sheriff.
Yeah, right.
I can't promise you perfection. No one can. But I can promise to always have your best interests at heart.
Things haven't been great for a while now, but we'll do better at protecting you from people like him.
The Crooked Man's been exploiting you, exploiting your hope for a better life. You would go to him for help. And he would take that weakness and add it to his strength.
Do you really think the Crooked Man cared about you? He just cared about your money. He cares about your obedience.
They're right.
You're all still afraid of him, even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over. And those girls will have their justice.
Yeah. Look, even old lady.
Very good, very good. The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded. The sheriff simply doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the
murders. Georgie was working for you. Bigby got a confession that...
A confession that nobody heard. Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke. Especially given Bigby's history.
What are you talking about?
Snow?
And what about your history? All you've done to this fucking town?
What do you mean there's no evidence?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this. I just
Of mean... course it's right! This man tormented all of you, for profit! Georgie
Let me
killed
just
him...
make sure I understand. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did, because he was working for me at the time, yes?
Yes.
Of course! Where are you going with this?
Well, by that logic, Miss White should be on trial for Tweedledum's murder, since you know Bigby works for her.
That's...
He killed a man.
That don't make him a murderer.
Doesn't it?
What happened with Tweedledum, I made a mistake. He was attacking me, and I just acted. I didn't think.
That's the only reason?
Bigby and I have already discussed his behavior that night. We're handling it internally.
Now, where have I heard that before? How about the way he treated the poor woodsman when he was in your custody? He was beaten to mashed apples while under your watch.
Under my
watch.
I didn't beat
him, though.
Maybe he's right.
Did you think we'd all just let that go?
That was Bluebeard, not me.
He was a murder suspect.
Besides, Crane was still deputy mayor when that happened. Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection. Oh, you're right, dear. Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
That's enough.
So, you won't answer for your employee's behavior, but I must perish for
this
mine.
This is completely different.
I did not order those two girls dead. It simply never happened. Georgie killed Faith and Lily. End of story. They want to scapegoat me for their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own
this
crimes.
This isn't right.
Oh, please.
This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you.
Listen, I know...
The laws apply when we need them.
Everyone, just shut the fuck up.
I mean, a certain level of privilege should be afforded to...
who?
This is how it's always
yes.
been.
See, this is exactly to what I'm speaking. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world. And ever since, which one of us has been there for you? Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you? Treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny. Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be
Bigby? Miss White!
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath, little
What's she doing here?
I'd like to... I need to say something.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
Of course. Go right ahead.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come here.
My dear, I don't...
Just shut up! You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. Hey. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
How are you?
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her? Did he?
Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Vivian killed herself. Back at the pudding and pie.
I'm sorry, I don't think
Nerissa!
I know your...
My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be
He
just...
ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you.
And this just confirms it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty!
Good enough for me.
Me too.
So that's it, right?
Calm down the witching well.
Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves!
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy?
You know we can't let you go free after this.
What did you expect to happen here? You're getting what you deserve.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence.
We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever. Somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic. That's not good enough.
Maybe
there will be more
point.
If he isn't
Hasn't
stopped.
There been enough I don't
so we get rid of him.
Too dangerous.
We can send
Everyone,
him away.
Everyone, listen up. Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment. So I think
this is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision.
Who?
I hope you aren't suggesting yourself.
We should have a vote. Make it democratic.
Do you really think that's going to work?
He's right. Nobody can agree on anything.
What about Bigby?
What about him?
He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
Oh, that's a bad idea.
That makes sense to me.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine. Are you sure? This isn't how it's...
It's what the people want, Miss White.
Okay. Mr. Wolf, it's your call.
Snow.
Just do what you think is right.
Yes, Sheriff.
Rip his head off, throw him in the well.
Do what you think is right.
Okay.
Teach him!
Okay, so what do we do here? We could kill him. Or we can imprison him. If we kill him, then that's the end of it. You know, we don't hear no more about him. But, you know, then we're not really any better than he is, right? And, like, that's technically the wrong thing to do. Probably. Maybe. But if we lock him up, right, there's a chance, like, he could come back. Which, this last episode, so, like, he's not gonna come back, but, like, realistically, like, logically, like, thinking about it, like, that could not work. Like, it has that possibility. But, like, I kind of don't want to kill him, because he, like, he's kind of cool. Okay, so, I think I'll kill him, or I'll, no. This is hard, to kill or not to kill, that is the question.
A fucking lesson.
No.
Everyone, I'm
not this way.
Oh, well. Well, now you're dead.
I hope you all remember this moment.
Think of me when you try to sleep.
You said you had a way to keep him from hurting people.
Wait, you can't be serious.
What he's done, you're just gonna put him in prison?
This isn't the way, Sheriff.
You're doing the right thing.
Yes, there's a way.
All right, do it.
That was probably the wrong thing to do, I feel. Like, I think everybody's mad at us now. It's okay, though. It's fine. Don't need them.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin.
Damn it, Colin. Stupid pig walking down the hallway.
Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. Well, I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
God damn it. Gotta reload, because, like, that stupid, this choice is blank. Makes me angry. Come on. Please. Please. I think my game crashed. This is great. If I click. Help? Okay. Who let the pork out? I don't know. Alright, where does it lead at, though? Or put me at? Cause, like, it didn't really end. Like, it didn't roll credits. But, like, I don't want to have to make that decision again, because if I'd have to make that decision again, I'm going to kill him. There we go. Oh, now it's the bird?
Not what I was expecting. Morning, crooked man.
He's got a sharp tongue. I thought it would be better for everyone if he parted with it.
Thanks, Greenleaf.
Let's just call it even.
Hey, Sheriff. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay, great.
This fucking line.
Oh, Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys.
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin.
It's the pig. Okay. Help.
Oh, Colin, Jesus.
We only have, like, 5 minutes.
And carry me, for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit! You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day. Shit! Just go grab that, would you? How are you, holding up? I know this isn't ideal for you.
Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance, but Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby, I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye. So, if you could bring it to her?
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best. It's a willow beetle. That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
Don't worry. You'll be a lot safer there. There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby, so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah. You don't have to worry about the Mundy seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Hey, Bigby. Where's your friend, Colin? Where's the fucking pig?
How should I know?
Saying goodbye?
Hi.
Hi.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh. Yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
need to let that go. How are you gonna move on if you...
Bigby, I know you're trying to help, but this is just something I need to do on my own. Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. I'm not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We're gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they'd go just to silence someone who had physical evidence?
Narissa, just tell me what happened.
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
You were just trying to protect them.
Yeah. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then... oh, God.
What happened? Can you tell me anything else?
I don't know what happened, but that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this, not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth? It was true enough.
I guess what's done is done.
I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... that night after Faith. I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her.
So, that piece of fabric I found near there, that was you?
Yeah. I cut my leg trying to get over the fence.
So you started all this?
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just fade.
like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us.
I'm sorry, Narissa. I'm sorry that's what it took to get me to pay attention.
It'll be different now. You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other and look out for us.
Snow doesn't really need me.
I'm sure that's not true. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You protected your friends, no matter the cost. And you brought justice to this town, finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I hope I've at least done some good here.
You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you. You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me.
You like my ribbon?
Do you like it?
Faith wore one too.
Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for.
I'll see you around, Wolf.
Alright. You and 68.6% of players killed Georgie. You and 89.6% of players brought the Crooked Man back alive. You and 47.4% of players chose to imprison the Crooked Man. You and 98.5% of players decided to accept TJ's gift for Snow. You and 54.8% of players. I hope I've done some good here. Alright, special stats, let's see, we lied to Beast about seeing Beauty outside the apartment. Beauty, we promised her we wouldn't tell Beast that we saw her outside the apartment, and we impressed her with our detective skills. We fought Bluebeard after the interrogation. Butcher, we offered him protection at the business office. Colin, we gave him a drink, and we helped him avoid the farm. Crooked Man, we took him back to the witching well, and we imprisoned him. Alright, dead people. We killed them. We gave Faith our money. Grin, we drank with him after the funeral. Snow, we brought her with us. We chose to wait for him. We accepted his beetle and promised to give it to Snow. And then we stood up for him when Snow wanted to send him to the farm. And Woody, you chose to arrest him at the trap bar. Oh. Alright. So, that was the last episode. Unless you're gonna pick up a graphic novel, in which case, you know, you still get to read some shit, but, I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna scratch my back. That's what I'm gonna do, or try to. Cause, like, you ever get this itchy on your back and you can't reach it? Alright. Anyway. anyway, it is 7 a.m. and I need to do some stuff. So that is going to be it for me. Thank you to everyone who joined and anyone that is still here. I don't know who's still here. Silver's still here, so thank you, Silver, for hanging out. It's much appreciated. I'm going to stream something else another day. Probably tomorrow or tonight. It's today's Monday, right? Today's Monday. So, yeah. Bye-bye!